वेलकम टू बृहन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन वर्चुअल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर एंड आई एम मिसेस स्नेहल कोडाम्बे योर इंग्लिश टीचर फ्रॉम VTC. लेट्स बिगिन विथ टुडेज सेशन.
हेलो माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू टुडेज सेशन. डियर चिल्ड्रन, एज यू नो इन लास्ट सम सेशंस वी आर लर्निंग अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल पार्ट ऑफ अवर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज, that is figures of speech. In last two sessions we have learnt about two figures of speech, right? Do you remember? You must have watched those videos which was telling you or giving you more information about figures of speech. First of all, in first part we have learned about personification, and in last session we have learned about, do you remember what did we learn in last session? Yes, alliteration, and you must have enjoyed it a lot. Now in today's session, as I promised in last session, that one more parts of speech in our standard 8 course book I'm going to introduce you. Now what is that? Okay, have some patience. We will begin this session with a very innovative way, and I hope you will enjoy it a lot. Now we will revise what we have learned in last session. Why figures of speech are used in English language? Because it make your writing colorful. It gives the colored aura to your writing. Okay, so that's why the use of figures of speech in our writing is very important in English language. Then at the same time we have learned the definition of the figures of speech. That is, a figure of speech is a word or phrase that possesses a separate meaning from its literal definition. In last session I have already explained you this. What is a figures of speech? That it, a figure of speech is a word or phrase that possesses a separate meaning from its literal definition. That is the definition or the meaning which we learn in our dictionary, or the definition or the meaning as we know. Shabdashaha arthapeksha kahi vegla arthane to shabd kiva shabd samuh jeva vaparla jato English madhe teva tela figure of speech asa matla jato. And we also learnt about it, that figures of speech make up a huge portion of the English language, making it more creative, more expressive, and just more interesting. How's that? That whenever you use different types of figures of speech in your writing in English language, then it gives a new look to your writing. It makes more creative, as we have seen personification examples. Okay, then it helps you to be more expressive. With less word you can express more to yourself, and it also makes your writing very interesting. Baga jeva apan ekada composition lito tevha apan phrases cha vapar karto kiwa apan kahi proverbs cha vapar karto. So that it becomes more creative, expressive and interesting too. जे छान composition लिहू शकतात त्यांना composition मध्ये चांगले mark असतात बघा. Why? Because we use all these figures of speech in our writing. So these three things we have learnt in last two sessions when we learnt about figures of speech. Okay. Now look at this word. Okay, and read it loudly. Pow. What is this word? Pow. Now when we read it loudly, we just enjoy it. आपल्याला खूप मजा येते बघा. असे काही शब्द असतात प्रत्येक लँग्वेज मध्ये असतात की जे आपल्याला परत परत ऐकायला, परत परत उच्चारायला आणि तो आनंद मिळवायला आपल्याला खूप आवडतं. एखादी गोष्ट आपण, एखादा शब्द आपण उच्चारला की तो आवाज कशाचा आहे हे आपल्याला तो शब्द वाचल्याबरोबर, ऐकल्याबरोबर, उच्चारल्याबरोबर लगेच लक्षात येतं. पाव. ओके, वी विल रीड, वी विल अटर, वी विल रीड लाउडली सम मोर वर्ड्स. Now see the next. Now here are some words, okay? You will read it loudly with me. Let the people laugh at you, but you enjoy these words, okay? 1, 2, 3, start. Boom. Splat. Crash. Bang. Wow. Zap. Pow. Whiff. My God. Pop. Smash. Ha ha ha. Oops. Vem. Poof. Yeah. So, enjoyed? Shall we read it once again? माझ्यावर हे शब्द तुम्ही मोठ्याने वाचायचे वाचायचेत म्हणजे ऍक्च्युली म्हणायचेत पण इथे आपल्याला बघून म्हणायचेत सो आय एम युजिंग द वर्ड लेट्स रीड इट ओके अँड एन्जॉय इट बघा प्रत्येक शब्द बोलताना आपण तो कधी बोलतो हे पण तुमच्या लक्षात येईल अँड यू विल रिअली एन्जॉय इट ओके 1, 2, 3 लेट्स स्टार्ट बूम स्प्लॅट क्रॅश बँग वाव Zap, pow, whiff, oh my god, OMGs, oh my god, pop, smash, ha ha, oops, wham, poof, yeah, enjoyed, majali, okay? आजच्या सेशनमध्ये मी तुम्हाला असे भरपूर शब्द दाखवणार आहे आणि आपण ते तुम्ही आणि मी मिळून आपण फक्त आज हे सगळे शब्द बोलायचे आहेत एवढंच आज आपण करायचंय आणि ह्याच्यातून आपल्याला आज गंमत किंवा मज्जा घ्यायची आहे वी हॅव टू जस्ट एन्जॉय दिस टुडे सेशन इज जस्ट टू एन्जॉय ओके नाव वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट विच वर्ड इज दिस Whenever we hear the sound of this bird, then we at that moment identify, even if we do not see this bird, but still we recognize whose sound is that. Coo-hoo! 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 Konacha aawaz asto? बघा आपण क्लास मध्ये बसलोय घरात बसलोय ट्रेन मध्ये आहोत बस मध्ये आहोत वेअर एव्हर वी आर जेव्हा आपण हा आवाज आपण ऐकतो आपण सुद्धा लगेच त्याला इमिटेट करतो कुहू आवाज आला की आपण पण म्हणतो कुहू कारण हा आवाज आपल्या सगळ्यांच्या ओळखीचा आहे आणि सगळ्यांचा आवडता आहे वी लाईक टू हिअर टू लिसन दिस साऊंड अँड टू इमिटेट दॅट आपण लगेच आपल्याला सगळ्यांना वाटतं आपण बोलूया कुहू So this is cuckoo bird, right? Kokel's awaz. Now next. So my dear children, as I told you, previous two sessions we have done with different types of figures of speech and they are, first of all we learn about personification, then we learn about alliteration, And in today's session, we are going to learn about one more figure of speech and that is onomatopoeia. Okay? So, just now we have enjoyed many words and their sounds. So, let's learn in detail what is onomatopoeia. Now, let's see what is onomatopoeia with amples of examples. आपण खूप सारे एक्झाम्पल्स बघून ऐकून बोलून वाचून ऑनोमॅटोपिया म्हणजे काय जाणून घेणार आहोत ओके सो हियर आर न्यू वर्ड्स फॉर यू व्हिस्पर व्हिस्पर व्हॉट इज व्हिस्पर व्हेन वी से समथिंग सायलेंटली इन लो व्हॉइस इन समवन्स इयर When we are sharing the secret, when we are talking about some other person, then we are whispering in our friend's ear and that is known as whisper. So whenever I read whisper, you know how it sounds. Haluch bolto jeva apan ekadyacha kanat. It is known as whisper. Repeat after me. Say loudly. No, no loudly. Say in low voice, whisper. Okay? Here, there is a cat. Okay? An animal. Now, whenever we look at the cat, what do we say? Meow. Meow. Right? Whenever you see any animal, you just, even that animal at that time are not making sounds, but you people make the sound. Whenever you look at the dog, you say bow bow. When you look at the cat, you say meow meow. Now, what is the sound of the cat is called purr. What it is? Purr. We say meow. When we look at the dog, we say bow bow. Bow bow. Bow bow. So, the sound related with dog is bow wow, related with cat is purr. It is also known as onomatopoeia. जेव्हा आपण एखादे प्राणी बघतो, पक्षी बघतो, आता मगाशी आपण कोकिळे बघितलं, कोकिळे पाहिलं की आपण कुहू कुहू करतो, चिमणी चिवचिव, कावळा कावकाव. अगदी लहानपणापासून आपल्याला आपल्या गोष्टींमधून गाण्यांमधून हे शिकवलेलं असतं. आणि हे जे पक्षी किंवा प्राणी किंवा एखादी गोष्ट, आता मी काय पुढे तुम्हाला दाखवणार आहे, हे जेव्हा आपण चित्र बघतो किंवा प्रत्यक्षात बघतो तेव्हा त्याचा साऊंड आपल्या डोक्यात पहिला येतो किंवा कानात आपल्याला येतो ऐकायला, जरी तो झाला नाही तरी, यालाच इंग्लिशमध्ये ऑनोमोटोपिया म्हणतात. इट इज व्हेरी सिम्पल. ओके, सो ॲज आय टोल्ड यू, वी आर गोइंग टू सी मेनी एक्झाम्पल्स अँड वी विल एन्जॉय दॅट. से मियाव. So, all these sounds are related with the animals. Cats purr, dogs bark. Okay, we say that. But their sounds are different. And the next is onomatopoeia. What is that? We will write it and read it and then we will move to the next example. So, a word that imitates the sound it represents. What is an onomatopoeia? A word that imitates the sound it represents. आत्ताच मी तुम्हाला सांगितलं की कोकिळे म्हटलं की कुहू कुहू, म्हणजे हा कुहू कुहू आवाज तुम्हाला जर स्पॅरोचं चित्र दाखवलं, चिमणीचं, तर तुम्ही म्हणाल का? नो. इट रिप्रेझेंट्स द कक्कू बर्ड. सो द साऊंड कुहू इमिटेट्स or represents the bird kakku, or as I told you that meow or bow wow. So these sound imitates the animals it represents, right? आपल्याला तो प्राणी, तो पक्षी, ती गोष्ट, हे आणि त्याचं साऊंड, हे एवढं आपल्या डोक्यात फिक्स असतं किंवा त्या गोष्टी त्याच्या बरोबर जोडलेल्या असतात. And this is known as onomatopoeia in English. Children, just now in short we have seen the meaning of word onomatopoeia. Now let's learn in detail, okay, how that word came into exist. The word onomatopoeia comes from the combination of two Greek words, onoma meaning name and poen meaning to make. So togetherly it is onomatopoeia, literally means to make a name or sound. Okay, हा शब्द कसा तयार झाला बघा. ऑनोमोटोपिया हा दोन ग्रीक शब्दांचा एक शब्द तयार झालेला आहे. ऑनोमा मिनिंग द नेम अँड पोएन मिनिंग टू मेक द साऊंड. सो ऑनोमोटोपिया लिटरली मीन्स टू मेक अ नेम ऑर साऊंड. सो वेन एव्हर वी सी द पिक्चर ऑफ द कक्कू, वी सेज कुहू. सो बिकॉज दॅट कक्कू मेक्स द साऊंड ऑफ कुहू, राईट? So that is what the literally meaning of the word onomatopoeia is, to make a name or make a sound. Okay, now let's read some sounds. That is to say that the word means nothing more than the sound it makes. In short, it is to say that the word means nothing more than the sound it makes. Onomatopoeia हा शब्द लक्षात आपल्याला आला किंवा आपल्याला समजा सांगितलं, फाइंड आउट द lines or find out the words contain the figure of speech onomatopoeia, की तुम्ही तिकडे जिथे साऊंड वाले शब्द आहेत त्याला अंडरलाइन करायचं होतं. सो दिस इज द इझिएस्ट वे टू फाइंड आउट द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच ऑनोमोटोपिया इन एनी पोएम और एनीवेअर. सो इन शॉर्ट द ऑनोमोटोपिया इज नथिंग मोर देन द साउंड इट मेक्स. Now, onomatopoeia is the process of creating a word that phonetically imitates, resembles, or suggests the sound that it describes. म्हणजे काय? तो onomatopoeia म्हणजे काय असतं की एखादा शब्द की जो आपल्याला आता जसं मी कक्कूचं तुम्हाला एक्झाम्पल दिलं की कोकिळ म्हटलं की आपल्याला कुहू. सो इट रिझेम्बल्स और इट सजेस्ट हू साउंड इज दॅट, हू साउंड are we describing, so that is known as onomatopoeia. Such a word itself is called an onomatopoeia. Kuhu is word called onomatopoeia. Bhau-bhau is onomatopoeia. Smash is onomatopoeia. Oh my god is onomatopoeia. Okay, हे जे आपण वेगवेगळे शब्द उच्चारतो याला हेच ऑनोमोटोपिया आहेत, आणखीन वेगळं काही नाही. सो कॉमन ऑनोमोटोपियाज include animal noises such as oink. Now whenever we hear this oink, we suddenly remember of the which animal? You know that? Meow, meow. Cat, roar, lion or tiger, chirp, birds, right? So whenever we listen to this sound or whenever we read these words, it resembles, it reminds, it imitates, it suggests the sound who all are making it. जेव्हा आपण हे वेगवेगळे शब्द ऐकतो, आवाज दर्शवणारे, ध्वनी दर्शवणारे, तेव्हा आपल्याला तो प्राणी किंवा तो पक्षी किंवा ती वस्तू, ती गोष्ट आठवते, आणि यालाच आपण ऑनोमोटोपिया असं म्हणायचं. ऑनोमोटोपिया इज अ वर्ड, इट सेल्फ इज कॉल्ड which word? The word which makes the sound is itself an onomatopoeia. Okay? ध्वनी दर्शक शब्द जो असतो त्यालाच ऑनोमोटोपिया असं म्हणतात. किती सोपं आहे बघा. Some more examples. Now you can see a baby. Okay? What that baby is doing? It is yawning. Right? Make the sound of yawn. Oh. Right? Whenever we are sleepy, you yawn. Not only human beings, even animals yawn. Oh, so this is yawn. So whenever we listen to this word yawn or whenever we read this word yawn, we just resemble it with the yawning. Right? There is a connection of that sound of yawning and this word. Now, if you listen to that word snore, घोरणं, जांभया देणं, हे शब्द जेव्हा आपण ऐकतो, आता कोणी ते घोरत नाहीये, पण लगेच तुमच्या कानामध्ये घोरण्याचा आवाज यायला लागतो. सो स्नोर, यॉन, दीज आर द ऑनोमोटोपियाज. As I told you, I'm going to show you so many examples. So there is no need of explaining you in another way. Okay? So see here, buzz. Who makes this sound? Honeybee. Okay? Whenever honeybees are roaming around, they are making this sound, buzz. So the sound of honeybees are known as buzz. Who buzz? Honeybees buzz. Okay? Got it? Look here. What is this? Yes, phone, telephone. So, someone is dialing someone else's number. So, when he will finish dialing, how it will ring there? What sound it will make? फोन आल्यावर कुठला साऊंड असतो, एस्पेशली लँडलाईन, बिकॉज ऑन मोबाईल फोन वी हॅव अवर डिफरंट टोन्स. ओके, बट इन वेन एव्हर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द लँडलाईन कॉल्स, ट्रिंग ट्रिंग, हाऊ डज इट रिंग? tring tring, tring tring. So in our songs also we say that tring tring telephone, tring tring telephone, right? So tring tring is word imitates or it reflects or it suggests that this is the telephone bell. So even if you will not look at the picture, you will tell me, ma'am, this is so easy, this is telephone's bell. So tring tring is nothing else but an onomatopoeia. Now, dear children, till yet we have learned what is onomatopoeia. We have seen so many examples. We made the sound. We read it. We enjoyed it. So we learned this figure of speech in different way. But now there is one more way which I'll going to introduce you. See, what is that way? That we will read some examples of onomatopoeia through the poem. Now, why poem? Because, my dear children, in our course book, in our English course book, we have to do some activities which is given in the workshop exercise regarding this, that find out some lines of the figure of speech on onomatopoeia. So let's read this poem. What is the title of this poem? The Noisy Recess. See, children, nowadays you all are at home, but whenever there are regular schools, we have recess, matli sutti. And what do we do in recess? We eat our tiffin and we go and play on the playground. So now the children from this poem, they are playing on the playground and what other things? Let's read. Which game are they playing? Just see there. Yes, your favorite game. Ah, scream the kids as they play. Stomp, stomp, go the feet. See their feet, look at their feet. Stomp, stomp, go the feet, tumbling down the path. Ah, scream the kids as they play. Stomp, stomp, go the feet, tumbling down the path. Bang, bang, go the kids, hitting the pole. Kids kicking soccer balls. Kids kicking soccer balls. Kick, kick, kick. Kick, kick, kick. Buzz, go the bees. Buzz, go the bees. Swish, swish, goes the ball into hoop. Swish goes the ball into the hoop. Tweet, tweet, screeches the weasel. Tweet, tweet, screeches the weasel. Time to go inside. Time to go inside. Now after watching this video, you pause here. Okay, and you find out the onomatopoeia from this poem and note down in your English notebook. Okay, let's read one more very interesting poem. See here, what can you see in the picture? Crack an egg, crack an egg, stir the butter, break the yolk, make it flutter, stroke the hit. Hear it sizzle, shake the salt, just a drizzle. We will read once it again. Crack an egg, stir the butter, break the yolk, make it flutter, stroke the heat, hear it sizzle, shake the salt, just a drizzle. So from these poem also you will find out the onomatopoeia, that is the word which makes the sound or which tells you what sound the things are doing from this poem. Okay, now we will see some more pictorial examples. Now we have seen the definition of the figure of speech onomatopoeia, then we have gone through some pictures, we have read, we have made the sounds, we have read some poems about it. Now again I have brought you some pictures. Why? I'll, I'm going to explain you that, but just look at the picture. Hoot. Now, who makes this sound? Do you remember anything? Or do you resemble anything with this sound? Hoot sound कोणाचं असतं बघा? काय आठवतंय? बघा आता मी तुम्हाला एक चित्र दाखवतो. Which bird is this? Yes, आता तुम्हाला कळेल. The owl hooted in the tree. आता इथे मी पिक्चर दाखवलंय, पण जर पिक्चर दाखवलं नसतं आणि फक्त सेंटेन्स दिलं असतं द आऊल हुटेड इन द ट्री, तरी पण तुम्हाला कळलं असतं की आऊल काय करतं, बरोबर? द आऊल हुटेड इन द ट्री. असे आपण आता पण काही एक्झाम्पल्स बघूया की प्रत्येक वेळेला काय तुम्हाला कोणी पिक्चर नाही दाखवणार, बट विदाऊट पिक्चर ऑल्सो आपल्याला त्याचा इम्पॅक्ट कसा असतो त्या साऊंडचा हे कळायला मी तुम्हाला आता आणखीन काही एक्झाम्पल्स दाखवते. बट ऑफकोर्स इन टुडेज session I'm going to show you these with pictures. See here next word, howl. Who makes this sound? Let's see some picture. Who makes the sound? Yes, wind. At night the wind was howling in the darkness. Zzzz. वाऱ्याचा पण बघा एक आवाज असतो. It is known as howling. Okay? At night the wind was howling in the darkness. Next, chatter. Now what is chatter? नुसतं तुम्हाला मी हा वर्ड दाखवला तर तुम्ही थोडस विचारात पडाल. But let's see it with picture. What is that? My teeth chattered as I stood in the snow. थंडी वाजली की आपले दात कसे होतात, दॅट साऊंड इज नोन एज चॅटरिंग साऊंड. माय टीथ चॅटर्ड एज अ स्टूड इन द स्नो, दॅट इज चॅटरिंग साऊंड. ओके, पॉप. नाउ व्हॉट इट रिमाइंड्स यू? Very funny, very easy. Popcorns, of course. Pop. That's why it is known as popcorns, right? Main word is corn, but you always say popcorn because it pops. The corn went pop in the pan. Pop. And you must have heard this sound many times. Pop. Next sound is beep 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 beep. What is that? You will say, miss, this is so easy. It is of course car's horn. Yeah, you are right. But when people honk, when do they honk frequently? Yes, when they are in traffic jam. Okay, the car horn beeped loudly. People keep on honking when they are in traffic jam and everyone is in hurry. So the car horn beeped loudly. So honking of horn, beep 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 beep, beep. And it reminds you about the car's horn. And we will see one more example. So the next, crunch, crunch, crunch. You must have heard this word for many times, but here in today's session we are going to see with different example. The leaves crunched under my feet. Whenever we walk on the dried leaves, then it makes the sound of crunching. Okay, the leaves crunched under my feet. सुकलेल्या बघा पालापाचोळ्यावरून आपण जर चाललो तर असा तो कुरकुर आवाज येतो. So it is known as crunch sound. Okay. आता आपण बघा आतापर्यंत बऱ्याच वेगवेगळ्या साऊंडच्या माध्यमातून ऑनोमोटोपिया म्हणजे काय हे जाणून घेण्याचा प्रयत्न केलेला आहे. नाउ वी विल रिवाइज व्हॉट वी हॅव लर्न. एन ऑनोमोटोपिया इज अ वर्ड दॅट ऍक्च्युअली लुक्स लाईक द साऊंड इट मेक्स अँड वी कॅन ऑलमोस्ट हिअर दोज साऊंड्स एज वी रीड. While reading also we can hear that sound, though we do not make those sounds, but even if you read that words you can hear those sound. It has that much strength that those sounds reminds you something, or it has the strength of making you listen to that sound, right? So it looks like the sound it makes, and we can almost hear those sounds as we hear. Not only listening, but we are hearing those sounds as we go on reading that. Crunch, pop, beep, kuhu, purr, bow. So all these, even if you read that, you almost hear those sounds. जरी आपण वाचत गेलो ना तरी आपल्याला असं वाटतं की आपण ते आवाज ऐकतोय. हिअर आर सम वर्ड्स दॅट आर युज्ड ॲज एक्झाम्पल ऑफ ऑनोमेटोपिया. बघा, आतापर्यंत मी तुम्हाला जे एक्झाम्पल्स दाखवले ना बाळांनो, ते पिक्चर्स होते किंवा पोएम मधून बघितले, आपण ते वाचले ऐकले, त्याच्याबरोबर पिक्चर्स होते. पण आता मी फक्त काही वर्ड्स वाचणार आहे, ते वाचून बघा तुमच्या कानावर ते साऊंड्स येतात का. स्लॅम, स्प्लॅश, बॅबल, वॅबल, गगल, मंबल अँड ब्लेक. सो दीज आर सम एक्झाम्पल्स ऑफ द ऑनोमेटोपिया. ओके, सो विदाउट पिक्टोरियल एक्झाम्पल्स आय हॅव शोन यू सम वर्ड्स ऑल्सो. व्हाइल रीडिंग यू कॅन ऑलमोस्ट हिअर दोज साऊंड. सो नाव वी विल कन्क्लूड ऑन दिस नोट वाय दिस फिगर ऑफ स्पीच इज यूज्ड इन इंग्लिश. इंग्लिश मध्ये या फिगर ऑफ स्पीचचा वापर का करतात ते आपण आता बघूया. जनरली वर्ड्स आर यूज्ड टू टेल व्हॉट इज हॅपनिंग, राईट. ऑनोमेटोपिया ऑन द अदर हँड हेल्प्स रीडर्स टू हिअर द साऊंड ऑफ द वर्ड्स दे रिफ्लेक्ट. हेन्स द रीडर कॅनॉट हेल्प बट एंटर द वर्ल्ड क्रिएटेड बाय द पोएट विथ द एड ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स, एस्पेशली दोज ऑनोमेटोपिया वर्ड्स ऑर दीज फिगर ऑफ स्पीच इज यूज्ड इन पोएम. वाय? बिकॉज इन पोएम, एज यू नो, पोएट हॅज टू वर्ड लेस वर्ड टू रिफ्लेक्स ऑर टू एक्सप्रेस मोर. सो हियर when the poet is using onomatopoeia, this figure of in his speech, then the reader enter in the world created by the poet with the help of these words. आता onomatopoeia चा इंग्लिश मध्ये का वापर करतात तर आपण असं बघितलं की जनरली शब्द जे असतात ते लेखक काय त्यांना कथा सांगण्यासाठी वगैरे वापरतात की काय होणार आहे पुढे, किंवा धडा लिहिण्यासाठी प्रोज पॅसेज मध्ये. पण ऑनोमॅटोपिया मध्ये आपण ऍक्च्युली ते शब्द ऐकतो, ही ताकद आहे या फिगर ऑफ स्पीचची. बाळांनो लक्षात घ्या की जेव्हा आपण ते शब्द उच्चारतो, उच्चारायच्या आधी आपण वाचतो, तेव्हा आपण प्रत्यक्ष ते शब्दाचा आवाज ऐकतो आपण, ही ताकद आहे, ही स्ट्रेंथ आहे त्या शब्दांमध्ये. आणि याचा उपयोग जास्तीत जास्त पोएट्स करतात कवितांमध्ये. सो दॅट व्हेन एव्हर वी आर रीडिंग, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू दॅट पोएम, वी enter in the world of the poet which we want to enter in his poems world, right. kavila je kai sangayche te tya shabdan madun to aplyala tyachi anubhuti deto, anubhav deto, aplyala te pratyaksha ahe he believe karayla he shabda madat kartat. so the reader cannot help but enter the world created by the poet with the aid of these words. aid means help of these words. So that is the strength of the onomatopoeia. Now here we will conclude with an activity from our course book. This activity is on page number 38. Activity, what is the activity? Pick out four lines that contain the figure of speech onomatopoeia. So after watching this video, you rewatch it, try to understand, take the experience and enjoy the words reading and reading aloud. Okay, feel those sounds, and after doing all these things, go on page number 38 of our course book and do this very sweet and small exercise.
That's all for today. So you will revise whatever we have learned in today's session. Please subscribe the channel and press the notification button to get the link of next video. Bye bye.